Hello students, welcome to my physics class. This is Shumi Roy from Techno India Group Public School, Siliguri. And today we are going to do awareness science solutions of chapter 12, friction. In our previous class, we have completed up to very short answer type questions. So today we are going to start with short answer type questions. The question number 36, that is first question of short answer type questions are: when we try to push a heavy box kept on ground, it does not move at all. Which force is preventing this box to move forward? Where does this force act? So as we already know that friction is the force which is doing this, and the friction always acts in the opposite direction. So you can write the answer like this: whenever we push a very heavy box kept on ground, it does not move at all because frictional force balances the force that we apply. So there is no net movement of this box. It acts in a direction opposite to the force we apply. So friction always acts in the opposite direction. This you have to always remember. Now let us move to the next question. The next question is, suppose your writing table or desk is tilted a little. A book kept on the table starts sliding down. Draw a diagram to show the direction of force of friction acting on the book. So the diagram is given. You can see that friction force is acting upward because the book is sliding downwards. So the friction force is a opposing force which acts from the opposite direction. So the friction force, direction of friction force will be opposite. So this arrow is very important. The arrow which is shown in the figure is very important. That shows the direction of frictional force. Next question is, which will cause more friction, a rough surface or a smooth surface, and why? A rough surface will have more friction because it is having more number of irregularities. So as it is having more number of irregularities, there will be more interlocking. So a rough surface will have more friction, and a smooth surface, as it is having very less number of irregularities, so interlocking will be less, so friction will be less. So you can write the answer like this: a rough surface will cause more friction than a smooth surface because rough surface offers more resistance to the other surface in contact as compared to the smooth surface. In smooth surfaces, there are very few irregularities. The friction is very less. But on rough surface, the irregularities are very large, so friction is large. Next question, explain why sliding friction is less than static friction. The sliding friction is less than static friction because in sliding friction, the interlocking of the two surfaces is for very short time. As the object is sliding, so interlocking of the two surfaces is for very short time. As we already know, the friction mainly arises due to the interlocking of irregularities between two surfaces. Okay, so in this given figure, you can see there are irregularities, and every object have these irregularities, and friction is due to the irregularities. Now, when an object is sliding on a surface, it is getting very less time to get interlocked with the other surface on which it is sliding. So, sliding friction is very less. So, in sliding friction, the time of interlocking is very less as one object slides over another object. Whereas in static friction, one object is rest over another object, thus the interlocking time is more. As the two surfaces could not properly come in contact with each other in sliding, due to which the magnitude of static friction is more than sliding friction. Next question is, what is meant by rolling friction? Rolling friction is the friction which opposes the motion when a body rolls over the surface of other object. Or else you can simply say that rolling friction comes into play when one object rolls on the surface of other object. Next question is, Iqbal has to push a lighter box and Seema has to push a similar heavier box on the same floor. Who will have to apply a large force and why? Seema will have to apply large force than Iqbal. This is because Seema's box is heavier and she has to apply greater force to overcome the larger friction. As we know, force of friction arises because of interlocking of irregularities of the two surfaces in contact. When a heavy object is placed on the floor, the interlocking of irregularities on the surface of box and floor becomes strong. This is because the two surfaces in contact are pressed harder. Hence, more force is required to overcome the interlock. Next question, why does a man slip when he steps on a banana peel thrown on the road? While walking on a road, a man slips if he steps on a banana peel because the banana peel acts as a lubricant between the road and the man's shoes, which reduces the friction, thus man slips on peel. So you can say a smooth surface, as it is acting as a lubricant, the smooth surface will have very less friction. So it will be very difficult for the man to walk on a banana peel. Next question is, car wheels often spin on icy roads. Explain why. A car spins on icy road because the treads of the car can no longer maintain the proper friction to keep it moving. Due to ice, the friction reduces and the car spins. As we know, ice is a very smooth surface. So on a smooth surface, the friction will be very less. So on a smooth surface, the tires of the car cannot make a proper grip. So they start spinning. Next question, explain why a pencil will write on paper but not on glass. A pencil is made of graphite. The paper surface offers more resistance to the pencil while we write on the paper. Means the friction force will be more. In this way, when the pencil is rubbed on the paper, some bits of graphite come on the paper and we are able to write. Whereas, glass offers no friction to the pencil. Therefore, we cannot write on a glass with pencil because glass is a smooth surface. And on a smooth surface, the friction will be very less. So, it will be impossible to write on a smooth surface with a pencil. Next, climbing a greasy pole is very difficult. Yes, here this greasy pole will act as a lubricant. This grease will act as a lubricant to cover up the irregularities of the pole. Now, a greasy pole is very smooth and a smooth surface will resist very less friction. It will offer very less friction so that the person's feet who is climbing cannot make a proper grip. So, he slips down again and again. So you can write, climbing a greasy pole is very difficult because a greasy pole offers very less resistance to the feet of the person climbing on it, due to which the person slips down again and again. Next question, why does a matchstick lights when we stick it on a rough surface? So here we have to remember that whenever friction is there, the friction produces heat. And a matchstick is lightened up due to the heat produced during friction. So when a matchstick is rubbed on rough surface, the surface produces friction. And we know that friction produces heat. Therefore, the matchstick lightens up. Next question, similar to the previous question, why it is difficult to light a matchstick by striking it on a smooth surface? Because the smooth surface offers very less friction, due to which very less heat is produced by it and the heat produced is not sufficient to lighten up the matchstick. Next question, which part wear away fast in shoes? Give a reason for your answer. The heels of the shoes get wear and tear first than the rest of the sole shoes. This is because the heel of the shoes is interacted with the ground more than the other part of the shoes, and due to friction, the treads of the shoe sole wear out slowly. Next question, why do brake pads of bicycle have to be replaced quite often? The brake pad of bicycle have to be replaced quite often because they wear out due to rubbing and also gather dirt, dust and the other matter on itself. So to allow proper functioning, they have to be replaced, so that they can make a better grip with the rim of the cycle and they can be used for applying brake. Question क्वेश्चन नंबर 49, पेंसिल इरेजर लूजेस टाइनी पीसेस ऑफ पेपर ईच टाइम यू यूज इट. व्हाई डज दिस हैपन? दिस इज बिकॉज द पेपर ऑफर्स more friction to the pencil eraser when we rub on the paper. Some bits of rubber come on the paper. So this is the regular activity you might have seen this many times in your while you have used your eraser, that some pieces of erasers, broken pieces of the rubber can be seen on the paper. This is due to the friction. Next question is, what happens when you rub our hands vigorously for a few seconds? Why does this happen? By rubbing our hands against each other, we create friction between our hands and this friction produces heat. Therefore, our hands becomes warm. Explain how friction enables us to walk without slipping. When we step forward and walk, we are applying force denoted by F on the ground. Now, in return, ground also applies a reaction force on us, because we know for every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. So, but we can fall if friction denoted by F is not present, as the large ground can apply a large force. If in the absence of friction, the force which is being applied by the ground will be more and we can slip, we cannot walk properly. So, friction is helping us, as friction is balancing the a force which is exerted by the ground on our foot. Because of that only we can walk steadily, or else in the absence of friction we could have slipped. Next question, why it is easier to hold in hand a kulhar? Kulhar means an earthen pot made up of mud, or a glass tumbler. Why? So it is easier to hold a kulhar, an earthen pot, because it has rougher surface as it is made up of mud. Mud offers more friction than glass and we are able to form a grip on the earthen pot. So mud, kulhar made up of mud will have rough surfaces, and we know rough surface will have more friction, and so that the grip can be better. Next question, how does a bicycle stop when its brakes are applied? When we apply brake, it stops the bicycle. A force of friction generates between the rim of the bicycle and the brakes. The friction is produced in opposite direction of motion, thus the bicycle is stopped. So this is very important. For applying a brakes, we have to use brake pads. And the brake pads creates a friction force with the rim, and finally the wheels of the bicycle stops, and slowly due to the friction between the tires and the ground, the tires eventually it comes to rest. Next question, explain why the soles of our shoes wear out gradually. The shoes rub on the ground while walking. The ground offers friction due to which the sole of shoes wear and tear out. Next, why do tires of cars wear out gradually? Same reason, the tires of car wear out due to friction produces between the tires and the ground when a car is moving. Next question, state two advantages and two disadvantages of friction. We have learned many advantages and many disadvantages. So firstly, disadvantages of friction. Friction always opposes the motion, and friction causes wearing and tear. Friction produces heat, which is not useful. So you can write any two disadvantages. And advantages are many. Friction help us to walk. Friction help us to draw and write on the surface. So these two examples I have taken. You can change your answers and you can write your own answers. Next question, explain why sportsmen use shoes with spikes. The sport people use shoes with spikes because spikes increases the friction with the ground and does not let the person slip or fall when running fast. So because of that only our sports people use shoes with spikes, because these spikes will increase the grip which they can make with the ground, so that they can run fast without the danger of falling. Next question, how will you reduce friction between those machine parts which rub against each other give the simplest method. So by applying any lubricant, for example grease, one can reduce friction between those machine parts which rub against each other to avoid wear and tear. Now next question is similar to our previous question. What is meant by lubrication? Why it is important? Lubrication means applying some additive to the parts of a machine to reduce the friction. It's important because it reduces the friction between the parts of the machine. So example, castor oil and grease. These are lubricants which are used in machines to reduce the friction so that the machine parts will not damage. It will not wear and tear with the continuous use. Next question is, explain why wheels are so useful. Wheels are important because they are used for transportation. Heavy machines can be moved from one place to another with the help of wheels. Because wheels can be rolled and the amount of force is also comparatively less. Next question, why are lubricants, oil or grease applied to rubbing surface of machines? So lubricants are applied to rubbing parts, rubbing surfaces of machines because when the part rub against each other, heat is produced. As we know, friction produces heat. So when two objects, machine parts rub against each other, they start producing heat. To avoid the wearing and tearing of machine parts, lubrication is done. So that the lubricant, whatever lubricant we have used, will cover the irregularities. It will fill up the irregularities and the machine parts will become smooth so that there will be less friction, and less friction means very less amount of heat will be produced, and so that it can protect the rubbing surfaces of the machines. Okay, and it reduces the friction and thus less heat is produced and then less friction is there. Next question, explain with the help of diagram how to use of oil reduces friction between two surfaces in contact with each other. So when we apply oil between two surfaces, say part 1 and part 2 of a machine, then the oil layer will allow less contact of the two surfaces with each other, as you can see in the figure below. So no need of writing all this, only you have to draw this figure. Next question, why are cars, aeroplanes and rockets streamlined? The cars, aeroplanes and rockets are streamlined so as to reduce the fluid friction. The air drag obstructs the vehicle to move forward and the fuel is consumed mainly for opposing this opposite frictional force. Therefore, the objects are given special shape called streamline shape, which itself cuts the air friction. So to reduce fluid friction, we have to make an object streamlined. Then only we can use those streamlined objects to reduce fluid friction. Next question is similar question. Explain why a speedboat has a streamlined shape. A speedboat has a streamlined shape so as to reduce the fluid friction as it moves in the water. Last question is, what are fluids? Named to common fluids. Fluids are those which do not have any shape and flow like liquids and gases. For example, air and water. You can say commonly liquid and gases combinedly, they are known as fluids. Student, with this, today we will end our class. In our next class, we are going to discuss the long answer type questions from your awareness science book. Thank you all for joining the class.